Hello, it's Bartosz. I had an amazing opportunity last week to go to Google's office in Zurich and sit down with both John Miller and Martin Split and talk a little bit about how Google is changing how they render our content, how they render JavaScript. And there are a few very exciting news for the SEO community. And let's start with the news, with the change number one, which is that for every single new website, as they called it, we can guess this is a new domain or just recently launched domain, Google is switching on JavaScript rendering or rendering by default.
No, so here's the thing. Pretty much every website, when we see them for the first time, goes through rendering. Mm-hmm. So there's no indexing before it hasn't been rendered. And there are certain heuristics that if we see after a while, like, oh, this page, actually, the renderer does not diff as much or doesn't diff. Like, it looks the way before. Like, we get, so what happens is we do a crawl, right? We do a crawl, which means, yeah, let's say you get a new domain.
You learn how much CPU this new domain was taking.
No. That's not what we do. What we do is we do an HTTP request. We get something back, right? Some HTML. Maybe it's it's a bare bones HTML, and all it does is load some JavaScript and run the JavaScript. Then this HTML that we got from the original HTTP GET request from the crawl goes into rendering. Rendering lines to JavaScript. Boom! A lot of content happened that wasn't there before. So we're like, aha. Oh, okay. So this needs to be rendered. But there is a heuristic that is very rarely...
So you look at the difference between the initial HTML and then if after rendering you see extra content.
They do it just to see if there is any difference between the rendered version of your content and the HTML, let's call it that, version of your website. If they see that when the rendering is switched on, your content is changing, they will keep it switched on for your website for long term. If they see that rendering is not changing anything within your content, your articles, let's say, your e-commerce products, they will switch off the rendering for you long term. So this is very, very interesting to have a little bit of insights into how Google is trying to address the problem of JavaScript, of rendering, and so on. So the second news from that Hangout is that we actually already mentioned that a little bit, but it seems that Google is, that was actually said by Martin Split, that Google is comparing the rendered version to the not rendered version.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the interesting thing is that, so what I want to make very, very clear, because I talked to the team and I was surprised about this, I thought this is still a lot more frequently happening that we are going like, oh, all right, we're going to skip rendering. It is not as frequently happening anymore. So like for many, many websites, even if they do not run JavaScript, they might still go through the render phase because it doesn't make a difference as much.
Because it's cheap for us.
It's cheap. It's cheaper than the complexity that we infer. So like there's very, very few cases. And the internals of that are very complicated. And I still haven't fully like grasped what exactly triggers the heuristic.
And this may sound fairly logical and simple, but it gets a little bit complicated here. Martin Split said that sometimes, and we don't really know when, it's a little bit easier for them to render even the HTML websites because this has less complexity than comparing the rendered version, not rendered version. So in general, you cannot really be sure if you have an HTML powered website, you have no like massive JavaScript changing everything, you still may go through two waves because it may be a little bit easier for Google to do that instead of comparing your rendered version to your not rendered version with each page. We are not really sure how it's gonna change things in the upcoming weeks or months, but this is something to look at when diagnosing the problems with rendering and seeing, okay, maybe we're gonna come up with some kind of experiment or a way to figure out, okay, is your website going through two waves or just one wave? And the third part is actually the most interesting, exciting. I don't know how to say that because it depends on the on where you sit here. But Google is slowly like fading away two waves in general.
Because what we see that there are quite a lot of JavaScript websites that never go to through like two waves, and there are some websites that go through two waves. Like we again, we don't see really a difference. So this.
Yeah.
It's, so one of the factors for you is like the difference between like the initial
crawl
HTML
and,
whatever
yeah,
or then the rendered DOM
yeah
and okay
crawl DOM
that's
and
interesting
DOM. And I wouldn't say that two waves of indexing are dead, but it's definitely something.
Oh, they're
that
not.
They're absolutely not. But it's definitely I expect eventually rendering, crawling, and indexing will come closer together. We're not there yet, but I know that teams are looking into it.
So you would
no plans, no deadlines, no roadmaps to be announced yet. But
you winked twice.
So we can expect Google to, which we actually talked about a few times here on our YouTube channel and on our blog, that YouTube is that Google is slowly fading away two waves of indexing, which seemed like a logical step, anyways. Martin Splitt said specifically that two waves play less and less of a role in indexing, so we can expect that within a few months or a year, or we actually don't know exactly, but that Google is gonna switch from two waves of indexing to simply rendering all the content straight away. We're definitely gonna be looking at this change very closely, not only through a little bit of experiments that we're running, but I would assume that if they announced it, it's gonna be either at Chrome Developer Summit this November or at Google I/O next year. So definitely keep watching for some kind of announcements about two waves of indexing. There are a few more things worth discussing after last Google Hangout, especially my favorite favorite topic, so death of JavaScript SEO, and my conversation about that with both John Miller and Martin Splitt. And we're going to definitely record a separate video about that, but these three takeaways here are the crucial things to implement into your daily workflow to play with a little bit. So if you have any questions, shoot them, like add them in the comments, subscribe, and thank you very much for watching.